duck said, quack, 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 quack. But only four little ducks came back.
Morning, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Going for a walk, I see. Chicken eggs. How curious. I wonder where their mother's gone. How wonderful! But still no mother. You'd better take care of these chicks until she returns. Do you think you can do it?
Yes! Pocoyo takes care!
You'd better follow them, Pocoyo. Maybe it's time to teach them to roost. Very good. Looks like you could use some help, Pocoyo. Maybe Pato?
No, Pato. Ellie, help Pocoyo.
Ellie? I bet she'd make a wonderful mother. Ellie? Will you help Pocoyo mind these chicks?
Hello,
This is curious. Looks like someone's got those chicks in line. But who?
It's Pato!
What a surprise! You make a better mother hen than we thought. Amazing! You've done it! What's next, Pato? Flying! But chickens don't fly. Unbelievable! You're a natural with these chicks. Well, you're just full of surprises, Pato. What could possibly be next? Oh no, Pato. What happened to your flock of chicks? Oh, their mothers found them at last. Well, of course, the chicks belong with their mother. Oh dear. Perhaps some rest will do you good. There we are, Pato. Get a good night's rest. Well, it looks like you've made new friends for good. Lovely. Good night, Pato. And good night to all.
Sleepy bird is sleepy. He feels happy.
Hi, sleepy bird. So, Settling in for a nap? Pogoyo, you're making too much noise.
Sorry.
Pogoyo, this noise is making it hard for Sleepy Bird to take her nap.
I'm sorry.
Good idea. Pogoyo promises to keep everything quiet from now on. He'll be your sleep guard. What's that? It's Nina and Roberto. They're playing tag. They're so rambunctious. I suppose tag is noisy, Pogoyo. But what can they do instead that's quiet? Ah, read a book. Much quieter. Pogoyo, it may be noisy, but Ellie must practice her tap dancing. What a great idea, Pogoyo! Sorry, I'll whisper from now on. Try now, Pato.
Noise?
I don't hear anything, Pogoyo. I don't hear a thing. What now? must have found every sound there is. Let's check on Sleepy Bird. Sound asleep. Well done, Pocoyo. Pocoyo? Ah. Sweet dreams. You've earned them. Bye-bye, all.
My friend's a little duck with a hat that's green. His little legs are orange and so is his beak. His body is yellow, his eyes are very large. His wings are very little, but he's got a big heart. His name is Pato and I love him so. Everything's better when we are together. His name is Pato, he has come to play. When he is happy, he quacks away.
Hello, Sleepy Bird. Oh, sorry. You go back to sleep, Sleepy Bird. Ah, hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Ah, come to see your old friend Sleepy Bird, have you? I'm afraid she's asleep as usual. Oh, wait a minute. Is she waking up? Oh, no. I think it's something else. Oh, my word. Oh, that was so close. Pocoyo? It's not actually a... Thank you, Pato. Yes, I suppose it does look like a ball, but it's shaped a little differently. Oh, I know. Can you help Pocoyo? Can any of you tell him what that is?
Egg!
It's an egg, Pocoyo.
Egg. Egg. An egg.
Phew, that's better. Eggs can break, I'm afraid, Pocoyo, if you're not careful. And do you know what's inside that egg waiting to come out? Ah, Pato knows. There's a baby bird inside that egg, Pocoyo.
Baby?
That's right. I had no idea Sleepy Bird was sitting on an egg. That egg belongs up there in Sleepy Bird's nest with its mother. Oh dear, you'd best catch it, Pocoyo. Sleepy Bird will be very worried if she wakes up. Oh, there it goes! Catch it, Pocoyo! Pato, you catch it now! No, it's coming the other way! Quickly, quickly! Pato, it's behind you! Oh, my word! Oh, well done! Now, if we could just get Sleepy Bird's attention. Sleepy Bird! Sleepy Bird! Sleepy Bird! She certainly is a sound sleeper, isn't she? Nothing wakes that bird up. I suppose we'll have to find a way to get it up there ourselves, then. Yes, I'm afraid it is quite high up, Pocoyo. Perhaps we need someone taller to help us. But who? Can any of you tell Pocoyo someone who is tall enough to help us?
Ellie!
That's right! Well done. That's where an egg belongs, snug in its nest. Hooray for Pocoyo! Something's happening to the egg.
Egg. Egg.
Oh, don't worry, Pocoyo. Come closer now. You won't want to miss this. Yes. It's a little sleepy bird. Or a little not-so-sleepy bird. Well, in any case, it looks like we all have a new friend who we'll be seeing more of. If we can catch him, that is. Bye-bye. See you soon. Say, wake up, sleepy bird, with me, she'll awake. Ready?
Wake up, sleepy bird! Wake up!
The phone! You've got to go out. I see. Ah, well, I'm sure you can find someone to babysit baby bird. Just ask.
No, you. Pato, please. Pato, Toddy.
Sleepy Bird wants to know if one of you can babysit Baby Bird for a while. No? What if the one who babysits doesn't have to tidy up? What's that, Pato? You'll babysit Baby Bird? Wonderful. So that means you'll do the tidying up, right, Pocoyo? Hello, baby bird. Have a nice nap. Your mother isn't here, baby bird. She's gone out for a little while. Now, baby bird. Look, it's your friend Caterpillar. You'll be happy if Caterpillar can stay with you. Well, that sounds like a good idea. Oh, yeah. They're copying you, Pato. Ah, feeding time. What? That's not what your mummy feeds you. cake? If Pato lets you have cake, will you stop crying and go straight to bed? Oh dear, Pato. It seems Caterpillar needs to use the toilet. Now! Quick, quick! Hurry, hurry! At last, time for bed. Your mother always takes you for a walk on the moon first. But you promised then you'll go straight to bed. Now to bed. Pato could really do with some help, Pocoyo. Babysitting is really hard work. I know. What if the two of you joined forces? What do you think? Should Pato and Pocoyo work together?
Yes! They should work together!
Baby Bird wants to know what you're doing, Pocoyo.
We sleep.
Ah, Pocoyo and Pato are sleepy and want to use your beds. Okay. No, you want Pocoyo and Pato to get their own beds. Well, okay. You guys did such a super job. Sleepy Bird wants you to babysit every day. Do you think they should babysit every day?
Yes! Yes, they should do it every day.
Oh, well. Hooray for teamwork. Bye-bye. See you soon.
Look,
there's Pato and Pocoyo. Hello there, Pocoyo. Hello, Pato.
Hello!
What's that they've got? Do any of you know what it is?
A ball!
It's a ball!
Yes, a ball! And it's a very nice ball. So red and bouncy. Is it a new one? I think Baby Bird rather likes the ball too. Hello, Baby Bird. Oh, there's nothing quite like a new ball, is there? Pocoyo, Pato, I believe Baby Bird would like to play with you. Poor Baby Bird. Pocoyo and Pato think he's too little to play with their ball. Oh dear. What are you going to do now, Pocoyo? Where's he gone now? Can any of you tell Pato and Pocoyo where Baby Bird is?
Up in the tree!
Oh no! He's flying away! However will you get your ball back now? Good thinking, Pocoyo, the Vamoosh. Pocoyo. Oh dear. Don't cry, Baby Bird. Can you help Pocoyo and Pato. What should Pocoyo and Pato do to make baby bird feel happy again?
Let him play!
Ah, you see, there's something even better than a new ball. Making a friend feel happy. Oh well, looks like all three of them are having a ball now. Hooray for Pocoyo! Bye-bye, see you soon. Baby bird. And hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Wow, look at that. Let's all clap. What's that, baby bird? You say that's the best ball bouncing you've ever seen in your whole life. Well, that's quite a compliment. You say that's the most amazing construction you've ever seen. Well, it's certainly a nice wall, but better than the pyramids in Egypt. Well, if you say so, baby bird. What's this? Ah, baby bird obviously thinks your drawing is something special, Pocoyo. Well, yes, of course it's art. But better than the Mona Lisa? Well. What that? A red carpet? Goodness! Well, I suppose nothing less will do for Baby Bird's hero.
Yay!
Hello, Pato. Says you've played enough, Pato. It's his turn now. Hello, Ellie. Ah, now this is fun. Baby Bird says pushing Pocoyo is his job, Ellie. Pocoyo says he's tired, Baby Bird. He'll see you later. Oh, Baby Bird, hello. Can any of you tell Baby Bird what or who is bothering Pocoyo?
Baby Bird!
You told Baby Bird to go away. Do you really want to see him again? You'll have to look through this telescope.
Sad.
Can any of you tell Pocoyo what he did that made Baby Bird sad?
He made him go away.
He made him go away.
That's right. After all, he only wanted to be your friend, Pocoyo. There, there, Baby Bird. Pocoyo didn't mean it. He just needed to be by himself for a while. What's this? An invitation. Someone wants you to come to a party, Baby Bird.
Sorry?
That was a nice apology, Pocoyo. What's that? You say that was the greatest apology ever? Hooray for Pocoyo and hooray for Baby Bird. Bye-bye. See you soon.
Formula Pato. Welcome to the Great Race of Pocoyo. And look at the wonderful trophy. Pato looks very sure that he's going to win it. And here are the pilots preparing their cars for the race. Aren't you doing anything, Pato? Oh, I see. You were waiting for a package. I wonder what it is. The Great Champion Engine. Now it's time to prepare your car. It's alive! Pato, your car is alive! But Pato, do you really think the car understands you? Oh, it does. Now the great race is about to begin. The pilots are revving their engines, ready to compete to see who's the fastest. Pato?
Pato?
Where's Pato? Oh, there he is. Everyone is finally here. On your marks, ready, go! I wouldn't celebrate yet, Pocoyo. Wow! Looks like nothing can stop you now, Pato. Nothing but the ball orchestra. Come on, don't be grumpy, Pato. What's wrong with dancing a little? Oh my. And the race continues. Pato overtakes Pocoyo. He's burning his tires, ladies and gentlemen. What a struggle for the lead. Pato prepares to overtake and... Oh, what's happening? Oh, it's Nina. It seems your car wants to play ball. Isn't that cute? I see you don't think so. Pato is back in the race. He's gaining on Ellie. He's very close, but... What's this? Oh, no. Watch out, Ellie. Saved. Thank goodness. Right, Pato? Pato? What are you doing, Pato? Camaraderie, what an example of fair play. And what a relaxing beauty treatment. The race is in the final straight. Pato passes Ellie, then Pocoyo. He's going for the finish line. Oh, so close. And Ellie is the winner, followed by Pocoyo. What a race, ladies and ducks!
The trophy!
That's it, the true winner of the race! Pato? Do you really think you deserve that trophy? It's for the car. He helped everyone, don't you agree? Maybe you didn't win the race, but you sure won a new friend. That's it. Hooray for a winning friendship. Goodbye. See you next time. Thank you.
Well, hello, baby bird. Oh, my! What was that? I see. Can any of you tell baby bird who that was?
It's Pocoyo and Pato!
You're right! It's Pocoyo and Pato. And it looks like they're out for a ride in the Vamoosh. What fun!
Hi!
Oh, I think Baby Bird wants to tell you something, Pocoyo. Baby Bird wants you to teach him to drive the Vamoosh, Pocoyo. Maybe if we all say please. Ready? Now. Please, Pocoyo. Oh, please. Please let him. Please teach him.
Okay. After lunch.
Ah. Pocoyo will teach you to drive the Vamoosh after lunch, Baby Bird. I think Baby Bird is afraid you might forget, Pocoyo.
Promise.
I think Baby Bird is ready for you to teach him now, Pocoyo.
After play.
But you said after lunch, Pocoyo. Okay. Now, Pocoyo?
Later.
I know, Baby Bird. This really isn't fair. After all, Pocoyo promised. Now, Baby Bird, I don't think you should be messing about with the Vamoosh before Pocoyo has an opportunity to... Baby Bird! I can't look. No, I can't watch. Wake up, Ellie! So, dear. Oh, not again. Are you going to save Baby Bird? think Pato wants you to push that big button, baby bird. Ah, excellent. Good work, Pato. Now, everyone, I know you're upset with Baby Bird, but it's not entirely his fault. After all, Pocoyo, you made him a promise. Can any of you remind Pocoyo what he promised Baby Bird?
He promised to teach him to drive the vamoose.
Yes, that's right. You did, Pocoyo, you know. You did. You promised.
Okay.
Ah, that's better. Hooray for Pocoyo and hooray for keeping promises. Bye-bye. See you soon.
Hello, baby bird. Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi. Up.
What are you doing?
Up and down.
You're playing up and down.
Down. Up.
Can you down. Say up and down?
Up. Down.
Do you understand up and down now, baby bird? No?
Professor Otto.
Now, class, pay attention. Professor Pato says, this is a planet, and this is an alien. The alien is above the planet, above. Now the alien is below the planet, below. Now he's behind the planet, behind. Now he's in front of the planet, in front of. Baby Bird, it's your turn. Can you tell Baby Bird where the alien is?
In front!
The alien is in front of the planet.
Hmm. It looks as if the angry alien has something he wants to say.
In front!
Wonderful! Now we've all learned about positions. Thank you, Professor Pato.
Lesson approved by Professor Pato.
What's this? A slide. This will explain up and down. Is Pocoyo going up or down?
Up! He's going up!
That's right. He's going up the ladder. And now, is Pocoyo going up or down?
Whee! He's going down!
Whee! Down the slide! Ready to go up, baby bird? Up you go! Down you go! Now do you understand up and down, baby bird? Oh dear. Number menu.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Ah, time for a nice lunch. It looks like Pato is ready to order. 8 carrots. Very good.
8 carrots.
Oh, dear. Well, how about 8 cherries instead?
8 cherries!
8 cherries. Ah, poor Pato. Can you tell Pato how many hearts there are?
8 hearts!
That's right, 8. The Vamoosh. This should really explain up and down. Can you tell Baby Bird which way they're going?
Up! They're going up!
That's right. Up, up, up!
Down!
Can you tell Baby Bird which way they're going now?
Down! They're going down!
That's right. Down! Well, Baby Bird, do you understand up and down now? You do? Wonderful. Good job, Pocoyo. What's that, Baby Bird? You say you understand up and down, but Caterpillar doesn't? Oh dear, it's going to be a long day.
And down, up, and down, above, below, in front, behind,
is that? Can any of you tell Pato what that is?
It's an egg, Pato.
It's a big egg.
Ah, you're right. I see. It is an egg. Fascinating. Oh, hello, Pocoyo.
Hello.
Dear, but... No, Pocoyo, you and Ellie have the wrong idea here. You see, that's not really a ball. What Pato has is an egg. And very soon, something will happen to that egg. It will hatch. Now do you see why that egg is so special to Pato? Oh dear, it's time, it's time! It's... It's a spider! I suppose ducklings aren't the only things that hatch from eggs. And some people are frightened of spiders, even baby ones. I'm afraid you've given Pato a fright, baby spider. Baby spider isn't that scary, Pato. And he seems to like you. There's Pocoyo and Ellie. Hello! Oh dear. I reckon they're still too scared to play with you as long as Baby Spider is around. Baby Spider, Papa Pato, has a game he wants to play. He wants you to count all the stones you can find. I suppose you can go and play with Pocoyo and Ellie now, Pato. Ah, Baby Spider found a stone. Papa Pato says keep counting. Can any of you tell Pato what Baby Spider would like to do?
Play ball.
Play!
I think you're right. He wants to play. Hello, baby bird. Oh dear. Pato says, take the pencil and go and do some colouring, Baby Spider. What's this? Can any of you tell Ellie and Pocoyo who did that nice drawing of them?
The spider!
Baby Spider!
You're right. Aww, that's so sweet! See? I knew once you got to know each other, you'd all be the best of friends. Hooray for Pato! Hooray for new friends! Bye-bye! See you soon!
Hello, Pato! Oh, I'm sorry. You'd like some peace and quiet, am I right? Well then, I'll be absolutely sure to... Ah. Right. Quiet. Ooh, a new mobile phone. It looks really cool. What do you plan to do with it? The first thing to do is to choose a good ringtone. Very catchy. It looks like you're not the only one who likes your ringtone, Pato. There, that's done it. Alone again. A nice quiet stroll alone. It's Ellie calling. Oh, I see. Ellie called you because she wanted your phone to make that ringtone again. Well, I can't say I blame her. It's Pocoyo. He must want to hear that. Oh, Pato, do come back. That song is just so catchy. You've set your phone to vibrate, which means you won't be bothered by anyone anymore. I suppose that makes sense. Look, all your friends are here. Why don't you put your phone down and go join them? Pato! Your phone! No one's calling? That's strange. No one again? Then where's that buzzing sound coming from? Oh, it's just sleepy birds snoring. Looks like it was a false alarm. Oh, I'm sorry, Pato. All the cake is gone. But there are plenty of carrot sticks. Pato, what is that you're playing on your phone? Well, that seems fun. But wouldn't you have more fun playing with your friends? No, don't throw it in the lake. Pato, it looks like Fred needs your phone. That's all right, isn't it? Why, it looks like he ordered a pizza. And Ellie's texted all your friends. There's that catchy tune. Isn't it wonderful, Pato? A dance party with pizza. What fun! Goodbye, everybody!
Hello, everyone! Oh, and Pato! Hello! Oops! Oh, dear, Pato! You do seem to be having a hard time keeping up. Oh, no, Pato. I didn't mean that you're too young to keep up with the others. What's that? Oh, it's a pair of sunglasses. And very grown-up looking, too. Is that how you wear sunglasses?
No!
Is that right?
No!
No!
How about that?
No!
Is that how you wear sunglasses?
Yes!
You look very stylish and very grown up, Pato. What was that, Pato? You think you need a new name? Something that goes with your new style? Oh, I know. Mr. Waddles. How about Sir Quacks-a-Lot? No. Señor Shades. Oh, wait, I've got it. How about Mr. Big Duck? Pato wants to know if you like the name Mr. Big Duck.
Yes, we like it.
Yes, I think that's it. Mr. Big Duck. The perfect name for a very grown-up duck.
Pato, play.
I think what Mr. Big Duck is trying to say, Pocoyo, is that he's too grown up to play with blocks. Mr. Big Duck, why don't you show Pocoyo what a big grown-up you are? Oh, you want to be a grown-up too, Pocoyo? Wow, you look very grown-up, Pocoyo. Oops! Hello, baby bird. Wow. Look at these cool grown-ups. Yes, yes, baby bird, we know. You're a grown-up too. Well, here we are. All grown up. Yes, sirree. Three cool dudes. Oh, phew. Hello, Ellie. I think Ellie wants you to play. Oh, yes, I forgot. It seems Mr. Big Duck and the others are too grown up to play. Oh, look! Ellie's finger painting. What fun! Oh, it seems these three are too grown up for things like finger paints. Look! Now Ellie's playing with building blocks, my favorite. Lovely. Nothing better than playing with a splendid train set. Look, Mr. Big Duck, I know you're all grown up and everything, but don't you think you're taking this a little too far? Now, Mr. Big Duck, don't be upset. Pocoyo couldn't help himself. He's not really a grown-up. He's just pretending. Just like you. Oh, look, a ball. Why don't you play with... that's to say, bounce the ball. Don't worry, Mr. Big Duck. Grown-ups bounce balls too. What do you think? Do you think Pato should join his friends?
Yes, yes, he should.
for Pato, hooray for Friends, and hooray for Pocoyo. Bye-bye. See you soon.
Bye.